That was a route run not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and put the down marker back to one.
So from Buccaneer territory now, it's first and 10 at the 46. Now they try the right side here. Room here to run. He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. 61 yards on the ground for him now on 9 carries.
They're making it look easy out there. Another first down. So far on this drive, let me do this little bit of math here. 4 plays, 3 first downs.
That's a pretty good recipe for success. Play action, lock. End zone caught. Touchdown, Seattle. A great play there. There to make the grab. And the Seahawks have a chance to tie things up as they trail by 2 here in the fourth. So part one of what they needed is done. They get in the end zone. Now you have to imagine we'll see a try for 2.
And that's what the book says, but defensively, they can't hang their head right here. They've still got a chance to come out with the lead if they make a play.
And Locke gonna try and throw for it. And he's got it. The conversion good, and we are tied in the fourth. Still time to work with on the clock, but they wanted the tie now, and they got it.
And I love their aggressiveness. Go ahead and get it done. Get the game tied. Now your team has the momentum, and you're staring across the field saying, let's see if you can match us.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And it's all on the line now, all even in this wild card matchup. Maybe their most important drive of the season coming up right now here, first and 10. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
And partner, in a tie game in the fourth quarter, you and I both know in the NFL, that's when you lean on your stars, and he came through with a nice catch right there.
Fournette, a first down carry. And he's going to take this one up only to about the 44-yard line. But Jordan Brooks on the tackle.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough and run support. And I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45.
Nice job, nice patience right there. Put him on the right side, let him work his way across, put the ball in his hands, and let him work his way upfield with a catch.
So from Seahawk territory now, it's first and 10 at the 44-yard line. From the gun, it's Brady. He's got Burton here. And some space here. And he's out of bounds, almost gets to the 10. A big connection on that one, 32 yards.
There's another big play for him right there, and that's not the first time we've said that throughout this game. This last catch puts him over 200 yards receiving for the ball game and leaving the defense with just one word in their mind, helpless.
Brady now on first down. And he hauls it in for the Buccaneer touchdown. The fourth touchdown pass of the game for Tom Brady. And the Buccaneers answer back with a touchdown of their own to break our tie and take the lead here in the fourth. Extra point up and good by Succop. And they will take a 7-point lead.
21.
Suckabon after the touchdown to kick it away. This taken in at the goal line. And he'll be brought down right on the chalk of the 20. Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. If they want to advance in this divisional round, look, obviously the time is now. Trailing here in the fourth as they go to work on a crucial drive, first and 10. 70 yards on the ground for him so far.
Playing against a 3-4 front is really challenging for offensive linemen because they can do so many different things. But when you're running the football, if you can handle the nose tackle up front and it may be a guard can slide up to the second level and block a linebacker, that's when you have success running the football.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And some room to work. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run, got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
Saw it through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's Seahawk football as we march toward a conclusion. They come up on a first and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive. Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. Call it a gain of 6 on the play, and it'll be second down.
Not in a position where they absolutely have to rush right now, but they definitely have to pick up the tempo a bit.
Lock. And this will go to Carson out wide. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. They're making steady progress, but I see your face. You're worried about that clock.
I'm worried about the clock, and at some point, you have to have a splash play in there as well.
The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. Rolling to his left. This is the tight end Fan. A gain of 6 there on first.
And remember, field goal does them no good in this situation.
You got to think they should be taking some shots for the end zone soon. On second down, it's Carson. And he'll take this one down to the 36. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 seconds to go in the game. So third and 2, and I count 6 defensive backs out there. Check 26, check 26. They stay on the ground. Again, it's Carson. And they'll get this one to about the 20-yard line. Now the Seahawks call the second of their 3 timeouts as the clock will stop with 33 seconds remaining. Locked to throw. Eluding the pressure right. And he's got the hook up here. Complete. Now Lock. Got a man and he hits him in stride. Now the Seahawks forced to use their third and final timeout as he'll stop it with 11 seconds remaining in the ball game. A looming decision to make on the conversion, down seven, but first things first, they need to score as they come up on first and goal. He'll buy some time right. It won't be a sack, but it's no gain, and it brings up second down.
Well, he strung it out as far as he could, and I like the fact that he kept his eyes downfield, but he finally ran out of time and room. But I'll take that over forcing it downfield and possibly having it intercepted.
On second down now, it's Carson, and he will push his way forward down to about the 3 yard line. The second down play, not much better than the first, just a gain of one there. They said beginning of the season they wanted to get past the wild card round. Well, they just got past the wild card round.
How about that, being able to put the big check marks up in the locker room, right? Yeah, you know, get to the wild card game, check, got that done. Win a wild card game, big check. Now you've got to go ahead and set your sights higher. There is a bigger prize out there, and they still have an opportunity.
the show. Flat rich kid got all of the clothes. People like you get all of the nose. I stay making wins, I stay with the pros. Just made a stack, I'm watching it grow. Up in the sky, everybody so low. I treat him like foe, he sleep on the floor. He don't got no money, I show him the dough. Oh no, kick him, never with a bozo. Name in his mouth like Froyo. With a rich baddie, looking for the bros. If he really with it, make him cash out the code.
Oh bro.
Any, many, miney, mo. All this money, I need mo. Don't want your bro, it was for show. Just so you know,
we just wanna get lit. We just wanna get lit. We just wanna get lit. We just wanna get lit, 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 lit. Any, many, miney, mo. All this money, I need mo. Don't want your bro, it was for show. Just so you know, we just wanna get lit. We just wanna get lit. We just wanna get lit. We just wanna get lit, 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 lit. Any, many, miney, mo. All this money, I need mo. Give him a show, killing you nose and taking your bro. I'm taking your man and spinning his bands.
And you either float or you sink. Moment of truth, credit check. You not a fool. BB King, I'm in love with the blues. Don't start me up, I got finishing moves. Look, salute when you see me. Slid through all the commotion. It's breaking news, they got an ad on TV. Popping out on them, a politic. And probably in a section where you not permitted. My honey's matching my Dodger fitted. Playing all goal, ain't no stopping in it. Look, salute when you see me. I bought her a CC and that was her purse. Disgusting with do for a purse, disgusting with do for the clout. I'm one of the realest, the realest could vouch. They thought I was done, but all that doubt. You gotta pay my next surround. Yeah. Salute when you see me. Put in the car to the my runner gets you speedy. Still thugging like the days when they weren't hearing my CD. Made it out of the trenches. Yeah, salute when you see me. Yeah, salute when you see me. I'm getting greedy, I blow the whole budget on me. That's on me, I'm conceited. Treaty, nah, that ain't how we treat it. This right here sound like a three-peat. I put the f*** in, it sound like I'm knee-deep. I'm like, oh, you too needy. Me and HB going Julie and BG. They gotta put my face on the box of Wheaties. I'm praying for whoever think they compete. Salute when you see me. That's all he ever, so that's how you greet me. I'm going TM 101 cheesy. And plus they got D2 on repeat. I'm with the love of my life in like 3 weeks, cause that's all I needed. She wanna go on a trip or retreat, but I'm sorry I never retreated. I set the bar so high that you might as well leave it. I'm going undefeated. I've broken the system, had to breach it. That's mission impossible, mission completed. Salute when you see me.
Yeah, I got the heart of a god and a genie. I want you to love me, I want you to need me. When I this face is feeding. I gotta get back to the hood. I remember when I was the needy. Clean me up, squeaky. She fell in love, deeply. They like what I say, they repeat me. All this money I be spending on BBs. That's why you gotta salute when you see me.
They talking about making industry music. They want me to cap to y'all, but ain't gon' cap to y'all, cause y'all went there when they ain't had a ball. He talking sporty.
We are pleased, as always, to be bringing you coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. Tonight, we kick off week 3 with a great Thursday night matchup between the Cincinnati Bengals and the Los Angeles Rams. And off we go from SoFi Stadium. Jamal Agnew now to return it. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line.
First and 10 at their own 28-yard line.
Now a play fake here on first down. Sliding out of the pocket. And his first pass is incomplete. Well, this defense for the Bengals, very strong last week as they helped their squad improve to 2-0 on the young season.
And what I saw on film was a nearly unstoppable pass rush. 5 sacks last week, plenty of hurries given up. So now what do you do on offense? You just max protect, keep everyone in and run the ball, or maybe just 1 or 2 receiver routes in order to try and keep your quarterback upright.
And 2nd and 10, he'll look to throw again. He's got his target. It's the tight end, Tyler Higbee. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Well, that tight end position, it just seems to continue to evolve every year in the NFL.
Yeah, you're getting really terrific athletes. A lot of them maybe were wide receivers at one point. They continue to give you speed, great hands, and big...
And this is going to be intercepted. Chidobe Awuzie with a pick. And the Bengals are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20. They may have thrown the interception, obviously less than ideal, but I think they also sent a message that they're going to push the ball downfield in this one.
Yeah, not afraid to take their shots right away, huh? What was that, like a 9-9-9 route? 9 meaning go? Just went ahead and went for it. Didn't work out so well because it certainly appeared the defense was prepared. But I'm with you. Okay, so it didn't work this time. Doesn't mean we won't try it again later.
Charles, Thursday night game, I think a lot of teams probably say shrink the playbook somewhat. Is that correct?
I think you're right about that because you just don't have the amount of time that you have in a normal week to put in a full playbook. So as you said, you shrink the playbook, pick out the plays that work best for you. You know what else you're looking for?
What's that?
Who are the freshest guys coming off of the last game to play on a Thursday night? Guys have a little extra pep in their step. You go to them early and often.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Now it's Burrow. Steps away to his left. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
So much for the best laid plans and best designed plays. That was good coverage along the sidelines. No place for that one to get in there. It sails incomplete.
Here we go. So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Burrow looking to pass. That one taken in by T. Higgins. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. And forget about the run to set up the pass. They're just coming out throwing.
Forget trying to set anything up. They feel like they have the advantage. They feel like they have the matchups, and they're just attacking right now.
Yep, going to the air on the opening drive. First down. Here's Burrow. Airing one out for Boyd. Got a man. It's caught inside the 10. And all the way in for a Cincinnati score. Tyler Boyd. His 2nd touchdown on the season. And the Bengals are on the board first on the road here in L.A. Extra point by McPherson, up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. Now Jamal Agnew from his end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line.
At their own 16-yard line.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. Winless to start the year at 0-2, and now they get the Thursday night game here in week 3. So I don't know, does the fact that they're back out so quickly, Charles, help or hurt their cause? The ball comes out, and the Bengals grab it. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And this is taken into the end zone. A fumble recovery and a Cincinnati touchdown. And McPherson on for the extra point. And it's good, and they have jumped out here to a quick 14-0 first quarter lead.
Bengals 14, Rams nothing. Evan McPherson.
So here's the kickoff now as he'll get it again following that fumble return for a score.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Rams take over 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And let's just say they're going to be looking to start over on this drive. A few moments ago, they were in the exact situation, but their first play led to a fumble that was returned for six.
Yeah, you definitely have to have a short memory to play in the NFL. You got to remember what you did wrong so you don't repeat it. But you can't dwell on it because then you will repeat it, and that's what you don't want to do.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Yeah, that one sailed on him. You've got to make sure you give your receiver a chance to come down inbounds because they are very gifted. They'll make the circus catches, but if they make them out of bounds, that does you no good.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. Looking middle, and it's incomplete.
And he's only hit on two of his first six passes. Time for a quick quarterback regroup here with a big third down coming up.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. They'll look to throw. Buying time to his left. And he's going to be stopped here a few yards short of the first as the tackle is made at the 33.
An 8-yard gain. It's fourth down.
They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. Got an open man. It's Michael Gallup. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49.
Well, they picked up the first down, but I'm just going to say it. I didn't like it before the ball was snapped, and I don't like it now that they picked it up. Think about field position on their own side of the 50. They don't get it. They put their defense in a bad spot, and it's just not a decision that pays off very often.
Well, it wasn't fourth and a yard. There was some meat on that bone.
There really was. Fortunate to get it in that situation, but not a call I would make very often.
The play action fake. They'll look to throw. He's going deep for Brown. That's into a crowd and intercepted. Picked off by Von Bell. And the Bengals are going to take over here at their own 22-yard line.
But to me, it's pretty simple, and it's fairly obvious, isn't it? He's got to start making better decisions with the ball.
That's now two interceptions in the first quarter. After interception number one, there was a long talk on the sideline, and now he's made another mistake.
Yeah, he's just been kind of laying these passes out there. He's kind of been floating them a little bit. He's got to be more decisive in his reads and definitely more decisive in throwing the ball. Rifle it in there every now and then.
And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing, playing against a good quarterback like he is, to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz scheme, and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
Burrow going to get this into the hands of Mixon, his running back. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. Just a terrific run there, Charles, from a running back who is so compact and powerful. And that strength was on display there. Throwing now, Burrow on first down. He gets this in the hands of Mixon. And he's out of bounds, almost gets to the 10.
Nice little nifty play for him there. Yeah, that's the ability to read a defense and utilize players that don't often get picked up in coverage easily. And I'm talking about being able to use the backs out of the backfield. Because I know that when I used to cover, hey, we got everybody cut. Oh, he just snuck out there, and they just got a nice first down there.
What do we love to say? Get those backs into space, right? And they were able to do that there. Nice pickup on first down. 14-0 the score. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Now a first and 10 at the 11. They're passing here, Joe Burrow. He'll drop this one down to Mixon. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And it'll be second and about a yard.
Brings up second and a yard at the 3-yard line.
The former second-round pick, this is Joe Mixon. And he takes it into the end zone. Touchdown, Bengals. Joe Mixon, His fourth touchdown on the year. And the Bengals, they widen their lead. Extra point by McPherson, up and good. And that makes the score 21 to zip. So after the made field goal, here's McPherson to send this one away.
Fair catch made at the 25.
He got this.
The Rams take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And two interceptions already here in this first half. That's got to affect him a little bit, right? He's got to be thinking about it.
He's got to be thinking about it, but most of the good ones, they find a way to put it aside. They're not happy about it by any stretch of the imagination. They find a way to put it aside and continue to play their game.
Can he put it aside? Let's find out. Just a couple on the pickup there, and now it's third down.
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
And a nickel look here for the Bengals as they try to defend this on third. On play action, they'll throw. Now a diving effort right sideline. He's got it. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45.
And the key number on that play, three. Third play of the drive, third down. Spectacular catch. Turns into a first down.
First down saves him from a three and out. Now this one to his tight end out on the right side.
Yards on the pickup brings up second and two.
Second and two. He's going to look deep down the field. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down.
As we've seen, their first two drives didn't yield anything points-wise. Certainly feels like they think to themselves, it's time to open this thing up, taking the big shot downfield.
On the move to his left. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30.
Looks to me, partner, like he's learned a little bit, because earlier in the game, I think he was trying to force a lot of throws into some windows that just weren't open.
Yeah, the interceptions had plagued him, especially a second interception, really a bad throw. So maybe a better decision there.
Yeah, no doubt about it. I think he learned from earlier in the game, and he's applying it now.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Looking to throw. And for the third time here this half, it's intercepted. Picked off near the 26. And he'll bring it all the way back, just a yard or two shy of midfield. Boy, so another interception, CD, and it feels like he's starting to unravel a little bit.
And as you would expect, still a work in progress here in his second season. He has to start ironing out some of these mistakes, though, because now his head coach, his offensive coaches, they have to evaluate whether you keep playing him and let him work through it, or you start thinking about going to his backup.
And they'll work this down to the 40-yard line, tackled there.
First down, Bengals.
Now Burrow on first down. He finds his running back, Mixon, and brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Burrow will throw. This goes out wide for Mixon. Fighting throw, and he's got space. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Second quarter action with 1:59 remaining. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw.
And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down. Something we haven't really seen much of from him, an incomplete pass.
Yeah, last week he finished at 70%. This week he's up over 80%. I don't know how you slow him down. Pass rush is usually the best way.
And that is caught. He's got it for a Bengal touchdown. Joe Mixon with his second touchdown of the game and fifth on the year. And the Bengals are able to add on to their first half lead. Extra point by McPherson, up and good. And the route is on here in this first half.
Rams nothing. Evan McPherson to kick off for Cincinnati.
After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. To return, here's Agnew. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And with three interceptions thrown already, we'll see, do they rely more on the ground? And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. It'll be a loss of 10, and it'll bring up second. Play fake. He'll look to throw. Catch is made by Marquise Brown. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. They go play action here on first down. Steps away. He'll check this down to Akers out of the backfield. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. Now a play fake here on first down. They'll roll him out right. And this is caught. It's Brown. Touchdown, Rams. Marquise Brown as the first half is winding down. And the Rams are able to cut into this lead in the final seconds of the first half. Oh, and it's no good. He tugged it wide left. And that will keep our score right where it is. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. The Bengals drive about to get going. And with a 3-score lead already, this is not time for a momentum change, so I'd imagine they'd be happy to just take this into the locker room. And defensively, they're just looking to keep him contained as they're able to get him down. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a second and 2. So we have reached halftime here, and it's the visiting Bengals out in front. As we send you to our EA Studios in Orlando, here's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, thanks very much. Fine work as always as we welcome you back for quarter number 3. The Bengals set to receive. They have the lead and the football to begin quarter number 3. And we will not have a run back here as the second half starts with a touchback. Here we go. The Bengals drive about to get going. Now the first half definitely went their way, and this would seem to be a great opportunity to kind of put this game a little closer out of reach with a score here.
Yeah, and it's a wonderful opportunity for them because if they can add 7 more to their lead before the other guys even see the football, that could be the decisive blow in this game. I think that's how they're eyeing it. That's how they're approaching it.
Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35.
And while we may be looking at the scoreboard, this offense certainly is not, because they're showing no signs of backing down, even with a 3-score lead here in the third quarter. I think they keep taking their shots. They've seen blown leads happen throughout this league. They don't want to fall victim to it themselves.
And he'll be out of bounds about a half to a full yard shy of the 5. A big play that time through the air. 31 yards. Now a chance to make that big play really hurt. It's first and goal just outside the 5. And Burrow going to throw again. Touchdown Bengals. That's caught. Joe Mixon from 6 yards away. And the Bengals take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. Extra point by McPherson, up and good. And that'll push the lead up to 29 now. So after the made field goal, here's McPherson to send this one away. From his end zone, here comes Agnew. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover. They want to try to put points on the board.
Now a throw right side taken in here to start this drive. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down.
21 yards. That's good.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Flushed out right. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45.
They're throwing it on first down, but no one was open, so he gets flushed out of the pocket, runs towards the sidelines, gets out of bounds with a good gain and a first down.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. He's got a man on the crossing route. That's Moore. Touchdown, LA! Rondale Moore, his first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Rams are able to draw a bit closer. They'll look to throw. Dancing to his left. And the Rams are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. And the formula there on the two-point try, they go 5 wide, not even the option to hand the ball off. They got it.
They tried to create space, and there isn't a whole lot of it there. For the defense, what you're trying to do is make sure that someone, if they're going to catch the ball, make them catch it behind you, because they run out of space with the back line. But in this case, the offense figured it out.
The Bengals drive about to get going. Still operating with a comfortable lead despite the score a moment ago as they begin first and 10. Now a throw here to his running back. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35.
This offensive game plan has just been sensational. I mean, when you think about all the different ways they've gotten their receivers open so far, it's really been impressive. Scheme, design, execution.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Now Burrow. And that is taken in by Hurst. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40.
Well, normally you see 3 tight ends in a formation. You have to think to yourself, this has got to be a run. And I know as a safety, when I saw that, I took an extra step or two towards the line of scrimmage. Instead, they threw the ball, and he found one of those tight ends for a very nice pickup.
Now a nice play defensively on first down as this is knocked away and incomplete. Well, thanks for joining us here on a Thursday night in the NFL. Third quarter, 2nd and 10 coming up. And that falls to the ground incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively. And now it brings up 3rd down. Now they face a 3rd and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Throwing again, it's Burrow. And he's got Hurst, his tight end. And they move this all the way down to the 9.
First and goal, Cincinnati.
They'll give it to Mixon. Down at the two. Broke through first contact, but ultimately stopped shy of the goal line. A good run on first down, and now they contemplate a second and goal situation. Here's a run with Mixon, and he will take it on in for a Bengals touchdown. Joe Mixon taking it in from 2 yards out, and the Bengals are able to grow their lead. Extra point by McPherson, up and good, and that'll increase their lead to 28.
Rams 14.
After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. From his end zone, here comes Agnew. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. They've got to dig down deep. I mean, they need something right now, really anything to cling on to. This offense has struggled.
Partner, join me in a walk to their locker room at the half, okay? Because I think what we would have seen is an offensive coordinator and his assistant coaches getting together with all their positions, then coming together as a group, going over adjustments, and then the head coach coming in and just screaming, wake up. Yeah. Let's get moving, guys.
I'm kind of glad we weren't in there at halftime, actually.
Well, you think you might have turned it on us, too?
Yeah, but right now, whatever was said hasn't been working.
They have to like what they've done defensively here at the outset of this drive. They forced a couple of incomplete passes, bring up a 3rd and 10. Don't be surprised to bring a little pressure on this snap.
And the defense loses him. It's complete. Touchdown, LA! This is something that we saw quite a bit at Oklahoma, and we'll be seeing it more and more on the NFL level as well. Marquise Brown going Hollywood.
And that's the kind of play where you have to kind of catch your breath afterwards. So just give me a second here, because when he shifted into high gear, he was an absolute blur out there. No substitute for speed. We talk about that all the time. The evidence was right there.
Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone.
First and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
There you go. The Bengals drive about to get going. And now you've got the clock winding down here in the third quarter. You're 3 scores to the good. What's your approach on this drive?
Too early to fully commit to playing the clock game. Yet, at the same time, you're also not going pell-mell like you would in two-minute offense. This is what NFL offenses call 4-minute football. Take the clock out of the game a little bit, wind it down, but at the same time, keep advancing the ball down the field.
First down, here's Burrow. And that's caught one more time by Boyd. And he gets us to the other side of midfield, across the 45 before going out.
This is just more of the same. This defense has had no answer on a lot of these throws. They've let these receivers run wild, and here's another completion for good yardage.
Burrow going to fake to Mixon and now look to throw. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Easy to tell who they're targeting on this drive. He caught the first two passes, but then this time unable to hook up.
But I don't think that that stops them from continuing to go back to him, do you?
No.
I mean, they've got a plan. They're trying to execute it.
And after that second catch, I saw him in the huddle. He said, hey, let's go back one more time. Didn't work there. To the air again, Burrow. Again, he'll target Boyd, this time successful. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Rams' 20-yard line. 1 quarter remains here in this Thursday night matchup. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. From the red zone now, here's Burrow, first down. And that is going to be incomplete as he led him a bit too much. They're still throwing the football here, and obviously the incompletion stops the clock. That's a bad thing.
Feels to me like they're just keeping them honest on defense, because you know they're going to stack the line of scrimmage and try and stop any type of a running play. Short little passes may work an exchange of running plays. Keep the clock moving. Keep them moving.
Yeah, I guess you're right. If they and that'll be caught. Touchdown, Bengals. It's Tyler Boyd. Tyler Boyd. His second touchdown of the night. And the Bengals are closing.
Cause y'all went there when they ain't had a ball. He talking sporty. Wonder how he felt watching his